Uganda has over 20,000 qualified engineers of different disciplines. However, only 1,789 engineers of this number, with 171 women, are registered with the Engineers Registration Board. This randomly means that a single engineer can handle over 10 engineering contracts, which is against the law. Officials have attached this figure to tendencies by some graduate engineers who switch focus to other endeavors, get better opportunities outside engineering as a profession, or just don't mind about registering. The chairman of the Engineers Registration Board, Engineer Dr. Isaac Mutenyo, has noted that the board is doing the best it can to bridge the gap, for instance, through continuous laying of strategies that equip engineers with more professional knowledge.
I think you saw how the Minister of Science and Technology explained that we are more of raw materials users and consumers, and there is a problem in the middle. So we have a continuous professional development policy where, apart from engineers having their knowledge from school, that we help them understand the aspects of practice.
In a recent research study piloted on two major western districts of Hoima and Kasese, it was found out that a bigger percentage of the infrastructure are way too substandard to imagine.
Look at Bundubujo, look at red areas, and come up with a comprehensive report and look at how to guide and inform the policies that the ministry and indeed government will put in place in the nearest possible future.
To remedy countless grievances that emerge as a result of masquerading engineers, various stakeholders want the government to expedite the enactment of the Engineering Professionals Bill into law. Part of their suggestions is for the law to regulate all companies and individuals, including merchants, foremen, individual engineers, and to streamline punitive measures to those who exhibit professional negligence.
We have asked government to expedite the enactment of the Engineering Professionals Bill, which is a law that has a lot of aspects beyond regulating only the engineers, because currently we are able to use that act only for the person, the individual.
So now we are going to go into practical engineering, and I don't think this is going to completely address, but we are hoping that once we have started this one and we've shown the country what it can do, we are now going to start regional centers too, such that there are centers from different parts of the country.
The Minister of Science, Technology and Innovations, Dr. Monica Msenera Masanza, who delivered the speaker's message, highlighted part of the government's agenda that centers on not only regulating the engineering sector, but to also financially enable it to achieve its developmental targets.
Adequate budget allocation shall be made to line ministries to facilitate timely updates of engineering standards. I further pledge government's full support and action towards ensuring a better policy and regulatory framework for the engineering professionals in our country.
In her absence, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, pledged $50 million to the Engineers' Circle of Uganda to be delivered in April this year. This was during the World Engineering Day celebrations that have been marked in three different occasions, including the Engineers' Run that was done yesterday, and the celebrations will be concluded tomorrow with 175 newly registered engineers taking oath. The sector is envisioned to encourage sustainable engineering, which aims at reducing material consumption, improving people's quality of life, and preserving natural resources for future generations. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.